Hello everyone, I'm Nick Hustedde, Technical Service Manager for FMC. Today we're in a field that will be planted to corn here in Du Bois County, Indiana. As you look around me, you can see an abundance of winter annual weed species because this field has not yet been burnt down with a herbicide. But instead of talking about weed control today, what we want to focus on are the migration patterns for black cutworm moths. So we have been getting some significant flights that have occurred over the past 3 weeks really in Du Bois County, but also in several counties throughout the state of Indiana in addition to Illinois. So when we get that significant flight, what that does is establishes a baseline for when we can expect to see first leaf feeding in addition to first cutting. So as we're identifying our black cutworm moths, really what we're looking for is that black dagger that'll be on the forewing, and that's a unique characteristic for those black cutworm moths. They do not overwinter in the Midwest. They're actually blown up from the south with our spring storms, and they seek winter annual vegetation to lay their eggs. So in this field, we have a dense population of mouse ear chickweed, which is gonna have hairs on the stems and leaves, in addition to common chickweed. So they are a preferred host for those black cutworms to lay their eggs. So when we get 200 growing degree units that have occurred from egg lay, we're typically gonna start to see first feeding, which will be shot holing on the leaf margins. And then as we accumulate 300 growing degree units after the significant flight, we could see first cutting. As we're out scouting, the larvae, really what we're looking for is kind of a light gray to black larva in color, and it is gonna have a greasy texture. They do most of their feeding at night, and oftentimes they're gonna burrow into the soil profile to get out of the sunlight during the day, so it can be a little bit tricky to scout. But as we're thinking about making those insecticide applications, if we're at threshold, we certainly want to go check multiple areas within that field to get a representative sample. And if we have three or more plants that are cut out of 100 throughout those multiple areas in the field, that would warrant an insecticide application. So typically what we recommend would be Mustang Maxx insecticide or Hero insecticide at 2.6 ounces for a rescue type of scenario. So as we think about segmenting between those two products, Mustang Maxx is gonna have excellent knockdown activity with Zeta Cypermethrin. We'll have some residual in season, but as we move into Hero, bringing the bifenthrin into that mix is going to provide the residual from a very stable bifenyl pyrethroid in addition to the knockdown with that Zeta Cypermethrin. So if we're out scouting, maybe prior to making that burn down herbicide application, and we're noticing some cutworm larvae present, we may go ahead and tank mix an insecticide such as Hero or Mustang in order to provide some preventative activity. In that type of scenario, we'd want to bump that use rate to 3 to 4 ounces.